Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just...
So how did you get your start in radio here at Iona?
My sophomore year, one of my roommates started doing a radio show with another one of my friends and asked me to come by and just talk about some issues that they were talking about that day. And at first, I didn't really know what was going on with radio, but when I came there, it just seemed really cool. It was a nice environment. The stuff we were talking about is just stuff we were talking about regularly in our dorm room, and the music they played was just, you know, whatever they wanted. So I found that cool and interesting that you get to just basically be yourself and express your personality through radio. 9th and something, not far from the train station at all. 59th and 3rd or something like that.
Well, that's the other side.
Yeah. Well, no. It's not far from the train station at all.
Well, I started with like TV first, and then I saw that there was a course on radio, and I was like, I always wanted to see what it was like to be like on radio and stuff. So I was like, let me take this course in introduction radio. And that was just more with like the editing process, which I didn't, that's not my thing really. But once I took this course and I got into studio, I love it. Like, this is what I want to do.
I'd rather do this than
edit, but... Yeah, me. Maybe you could join.
Can I?
But you have to bring your sports segment to here. Maybe we could do that.
Is that what
I... We have negotiating to do with Michael.
Well, how did you get into broadcasting at first?
I used to wake up watching, like, Kathy Lee and Hoda, and I said, oh my god, they're best friends, they're talking on TV, they're giving you the news, entertainment. I said, this is my life. I want to be paid talking to people and making them happy. That was my dream, and still is now.
And I'm hanging out, I thought it was a good idea, and then all of a sudden I'm trying to get back in, and I couldn't get in. So I'm banging on a door, I'm like, someone please help. And my friend sees it, she takes my phone, she's taking pictures. Thank God there's a magazine outside, because she's shouting out through the window, I need to call the engineer, we can't open the door.
Going to the studio, actually, like, that's when I feel like I can just express myself. And like with the radio, like, you're not limited to things, you're not restricted to, like, as if TV, as you were with TV. Like, there's so many regulations and stuff like that, but of course there's some regulations with radio, but I feel like you can just be so opinionated, and that's who I am.
Which bar?
I mean, I went to McFadden's, and then I went to Connolly's. I know, and you know what f***s me off? $20 to get in, and no drink specials. Where's that?
What have you enjoyed the most about this whole experience?
The people I work with, just great people, you know, we have great chemistry. I don't think there's just any moment where we just kind of stop and just like freeze up, like, oh, what should we talk about now, you know? Stuff just keeps moving, keeps rolling. No matter what music we play or whatever, we all just kind of vibe off each other, and it just works well.
Well, I never expected myself to love radio as much as I do now from working on it with you guys, while working with the radio team. It's been so much fun. At first, it was all about the camera and, you know, showing my face, because I'm a very, very lax person, so my voice isn't very projective, but I guess from being on the radio, I've developed this confidence where I'm speaking louder, and I'm just, it's all about personality on a radio versus TV, where you look at the person and you're like, okay, you see them, you know what's going on, their facial expressions and stuff, versus their voice, like radio.
That's that song, like, you need to get out of here.
Yeah, like,
yes,
let's be out.
I was never feeling it with Sweet Caroline. I don't know why everyone jumps around. I'm like, I'm actually, like, done with this song. And Electric Slide when they start playing all that stuff.
Only at weddings.
Mike's a great teacher. I mean, he's so experienced, and this is what we need. He's done so much for this department so far, and I feel that his talents and like connections help us students as well. Like, he worked for Sirius, he worked for the Giants. Like, that's definitely a big help for us looking for jobs in the future. And he knows what he's doing. It's so laid back. Like, you know, that's what you need. Because, like, TV, radio, and stuff, it's a laid back business, but it's very, like, down, like, gritty, you know. But, like, I feel like he could do a lot of different things with this department, and this is what our school needs.
He's changed around completely. The last guy, you know, was barely here, barely doing his job. Mike's fully committed and really, really wants to be a part of this school and make it better. Like, it's not like he's just doing his job. It's something that you can see he enjoys doing, and he's trying to bring it up to its full potential of what it should and used to be.
Yeah, he definitely has. I've seen so many kids around campus filming things, which I wasn't used to. I wish that Demergis came in when I was a freshman, because then maybe I would have had my demo tape ready when I was a senior. I'm seeing, you know, a lot of students, interviewing Eli Manning, and I'm looking at these pictures like, okay, when did this happen and why wasn't I aware of this? He definitely helped change the tables around a lot. And I'm sure that with him being around in the future, by the time we leave and probably have jobs and, you know, we're settled with our lives, we're going to see Iona be this flourishing heart of, like, creativity and mass communication.
I would like to see it hopefully become a very successful. Like, I feel like Kyle said before, we need to have kids, like students, listening, because if the students aren't listening, we're not doing our job. And hopefully, maybe it's a long shot, but like maybe we could be like on a radio station, like in the car, you know what I'm saying? Like on XM or like, you know, and even on Sirius, we can definitely do that, you know, because we talk about the same stuff that normal radio stations do, but they're obviously just well known. And I feel like we have a great opportunity to make this WICR successful.
I'd like to see everybody listening to it. I'd like to see it playing throughout dorm rooms before people go out to parties and stuff like that. I'd like it to be heard throughout the La Penta, Spelman area, you know, without a question, like people listening to it without even thinking like, oh, let's turn this noise off. Like, no, let's listen to it because WICR is on right now. This is what we need to listen to. Forget High 97, 700, all this other stuff. Local Iona radio. It's for the people, for the college students. You know, that's us right here.
I really hope that people tune into WICR. Like, I hope that the word gets around, you know, through Facebook, through Twitter. Everyone's aware of it on campus. So then they can just get excited for certain people and personalities and say, like, okay, it's 2 o'clock. It's time to listen to the show and hear what's going on campus, celebrity news, relationship advice, because working with WICR and the people I'm with, we're like a family. We're friends. We talk about things. I wish, as an outsider, that I had this crew tell me things about relationship advice and celebrity news, because I feel like we have a lot to say. We're kids. We can all relate to each other, and it's great information. Bye.
Here's some Chris Rock speech.
Oh my God, nice. You said the F word.
I don't think anyone heard it. I was pretty far away.
3 feet? No, it echoed.
I think I was pretty far away. No. What's my song, Gypsy Woman?
Alright, let's break this down.
We're starting this over. I get it.
Maybe.
I'll get a drink. I'll join you. Is the after party in Quiznos now?
Pretty thirsty right now.
Are you recording this, or
I'm
just doing this for
a while? Nah, we're all out. He's already got his cake. I don't want my cake from the birthday. I want my cake.
Alright, now we have to break it down, right?